Hi everyone. So today in this video we will talk about how we can load a data lake file, CSV file, to Snowflake table. So I have one Snowflake table here, and let's see what we have right now. So there are a couple of records I was testing, so I'm going to truncate that table. Let's see. Okay, and let's see, check it, and now it is empty. So basically we want to load this table using this CSV file data. Okay, so CSV file contains this information, almost 10k records here. Okay, and our approach is to, like, we will read a file from Azure Data Lake and temporarily store into our on-prem. Okay, so basically it's my laptop right now, so on my D drive I will store this file somewhere here. Okay, you can see this folder. So right now I'm just deleting this file, folder file. Okay, so this is our temporary storage from Azure to on-prem, and from here on-prem to Snowflake table. So that's the way we are going to do that. Okay, so for that we have this job ready. I just created this job and tested and validated before I do this video. So this is ready. So I'm going to explain each and every part of this job, okay, and how it is going to execute and what it will do. So in this video we will try to cover some additional information like pre-job and post-job and Snowflake. So these three things are additional than the previous video. So you will find the previous video link here, where we are doing on-prem CSV file to Azure Data Lake, how we will load on-prem CSV file to Azure Data Lake. So if you are interested, go ahead and watch that video. Okay, so for this video we have pre-job and post-job. That is nothing but it will assure the execution before your actual job and after your actual job. So in that case, like for example, I want to do some connection, I want to do some Snowflake connection, for example here. So this I'm doing into pre-job, and then authentication access to Azure Data Lake I'm doing into pre-job. Now once this connection open, I will do data insert into my database, Snowflake database, and everything is done, this entire portion is done. Then I want to do my post-job execution, where I will close the connection of that particular open connection. So I will close it here, and some messages using tJava component. So tJava component right now I'm using for system out print align. That is nothing but to display some information on your console on this execution window. Okay, so in pre-job I'm going to create my connection, I'm going to get access to my Azure container. Okay, and then I will perform the actual job, actual data process. So let's go through first the Snowflake connection. So in that, once you get the Snowflake connection from your palette, okay, so if you find this one, so by default you will find this settings. So either you can write it down, all the settings here, or what you can do, you can go to your metadata section and create a Snowflake connection here with the other information. So I will show you what I have done here. So I will go and say edit. So I created a connection once, and I will reuse this connection again and again. So that's the ideal way you should go with. Now here you will have your account information. This is just a name of your connection, as SFC Snowflake connection I have just given. Now this is important. What is the account? Account is nothing but your this particular portion. Okay, remove the HTTP. So anything before your snowflakecomputing.com, that is your actual account. So I just copied that one, pasted here. Then you will have your user ID, password, and warehouse. What is your warehouse name? Okay, so this is all information. Then schema and database. So let's see, you will find this information here, compute, warehouse, demo, TV. So here as well you will find it, or you can go it here somewhere, warehouse. What is the warehouse you have? Compute. Then you have database. Under that you have some table names or schema or view, whatever. So this is all information you will find from your Snowflake account. Once that is done, you will just click on test. Okay, make sure you have successful connection. It will take few seconds. Okay, it's done. So connection is successful, we are good. Next, it will ask you, you know, to select the number of tables you have under this schema. Okay, so we already have selected. Let's say finish. It will take a few more seconds. Okay, once it is done, I have already done, that's why it's asking to update. So now once this is done, connection, okay, what I will do, I will take this connection from the palette and I will go and select repository and then go this selection part and select this my newly created connection. So what it will do, it will automatically pop up the information here and fill the information here, and we are good. So this is the same thing happening here. Okay, so no need to worry, I just show you guys. So I'm going to delete this. Seriously, I created now second. Okay, so first is I want to make sure my connection is ready. Second is I want to make sure my Azure authorized and access is ready. So for that, what I have done is I will go to metadata, I will go to Azure, I will say create a new Azure storage account, storage connection, sorry. So once that is done, I will show you what I have done here. So in that, it's straightforward, you need account name. Okay, this particular thing I have covered into previous video, and the link is in your I button here on top, your left or right, I don't know, but it's there. Okay, so you can find that link. Go ahead and watch the video and find how you can do that. It's straightforward. You need account name and you need a authorization key. Once you have your account key, you can click on test and everything is good, successful, fine, you're good to go. So this two, I want to do it check first, and once this two is successful is done, I want to print a message. Okay, my Snowflake connection is open, then my Azure Data Lake access authentication is successful. Once this two things is done, then I am going to perform the actual task. Okay, now what is the actual task is, first we want to get a list of storage information. Basically, I want to take a list of the files that is exist into my container, and under that container, whatever folder, okay, actual blob, okay, the actual container is called blob. Okay. So in this case, I want that list, but I have only one file right now, so that's not that much important. But let's say I will use this Azure storage list with container, okay. First is a connection, so you already have connection, you will use this connection AZC. Then you will pass your DAO, that is your container name. Then you will pass folder information or blob filter. Okay, under this, you will select the subdirectories. Okay, if there are. But this is what, now what it will do, this list will do, it will go straight forward to AZ2022 and pick all the blobs under that and hold it. Okay, and then iterate it, okay, one by one. So here we are using iterate. Okay, so it will send one after another that blob full path to Azure storage gate. Okay, so list will give me the list of files with your current path, folder, whatever the information is there, and then gate Azure, tAzure storage gate will actually download that data, that blob, to my local directory. So let's see what is the settings here. So first is connection, again it's a similar container information, somehow it's needed. Then local folder where I want to put this blob, then my blob prefix, this is not a filter. Okay, now this, what is the blob actually? So the blob will come from the tAzure storage list. So this tAzure storage list, nothing, but on left hand side in outline you will find tAzure storage list, the current blob. Okay, so blob, I will you can take it here, or I will show you how you can do it. So just by default delete and say tAzure, you can type a little bit and then press control space. So control space bar will give you the list, okay, based on the search, and you will find container, local folder, and current blob. So this is what I want, so double click it, so you will find it. Okay, so this is how I have added. So it's not needed right now, so I'm removing it. Control S, save, and you, these are the default settings, subjects and all, I don't need it, but this is the actual blob. So this is how, so it will give you the list and information, and it will pass that information to StorageGet, and this storage, Azure StorageGet will actually download the file and dump into this folder. Okay, once this is done, what we will do, we will just print a message, these things are done. Now next, on this in this entire job, or we can call it sub job, okay, once these two, three things are done, what I want to do now, I will pick one T file, input delimiter, that can read the CSV file, okay, set the properties. Again, this information you will find into my previous video as well, okay. So here what we will do is, we will first select a repository, okay. Here instead of in the schema, we will use a repository, and then we will select, you know, this file schema, okay. Don't forget, I want this file schema, okay. So I will use this file schema that is already exist, we created into metadata here, okay, that I am going to use. And then this will have a comma, okay, because the delimiter is comma, and then everything is fine, okay, we are good here. So this is the setting you have to do for your input delimiter. Next, we are using the main here, okay, output main row here, we are not iterating, so there is another one is main. So in main you will have this schema information, and that main will go to your tdb output of Snowflake. So tdb output of Snowflake, let me just quickly go to Snowflake output, okay. Okay, so this is the raw one, okay, and let's see what we have. So here, if we are going to use the new created one, so you have to write down this all information here, account information, business. But if you go to your repository and you will pick what you have already created, okay, and say okay, then it will automatically pick fill this information, okay. So this is another way, okay. One more option is available, that is use this component. Let's say I will take another one output, okay. In that, what I will do, I will you can read it. So either you can go to built-in, or you can directly the connection component, use this component. So this is already created as SFC. I want to use this one, so it is straightforward. So it reduces all the unwanted settings. So because all the things will under this connection. Now here it will ask only for table information and schema information. So schema information, basically I want to use as it is. So what I will go to repository, and then select the file schema what I have, okay, select okay. Okay, so automatically what it will do, it will give me a table name, okay, and schema. And here now table action, what I want to do is like I want to do some truncation, okay, truncate the table and then insert, and on die error, it will throw error. So this is what my settings are. So let me delete this one and just show you the original one. So schema is delimited as a superstore, and the table name, and then I want to truncate and insert the entire thing. If something goes wrong, so it will throw an error on die. Okay, once this is done, again I will print, okay, how many number of records I inserted, okay. So for that, what I did, how you will get the number of records, so this component can give you the number of records. That's the beauty of this components, okay. So it will give you how many actual components, actually records are inserted using this tdb output. So that we will use into our output println. So you will find on your outline, so I want tdb output, so tdb output is here, tdb output, and in tdb output you will find a number of success and rejected. So number of success is there, rejected is there, and also there is the number of line. So number of line will nothing but your count here. See, this is based on the situation it will vary, but for this simple situation or use case, number of line is your number of records, okay. So that's what I'm using tdb output, one number of line, okay, that's what my current counts. Okay, so one, this is done successfully. Okay, this entire job. Now what I want to do, I just want to load anything that should be happened after my actual job is done, my process is done. So basically what I want to do, I want to close my connection. So I will use tdb close and I will pass my connection component here, this one. Okay, did that. So this particular connection I'm closing here. Okay, and then I'm just printing some message. Okay, that's fine. Now, okay, let's check it again. I have my worksheet here. Okay, under that, I have my table. It is blank. I have my file ready here. And my folder is empty right now. Okay, let's execute the talent job. Okay, so it is started now. Take a few seconds, it will start from here. As you see, this is the first part, pre-job is executing. So it will check my connection, okay, Azure authentication, okay, print message is done. Then it started actually the file, it is also done. File is written back to this location and it started reading the file now. Once the file is reading done and inserting is done here into tDB output, it will print a message using this and then close the connection. So it's still going on here. Take a few more seconds. It is. Let's take a while. Okay, so it's writing is done. Okay, total number of records are there into tDB output, and this message are print. Then this connection is closed and then messages are printed. Okay, so our job is successfully executed. Now we can see, on the local folder, yeah, we have the file. Then go to our Snowflake and see data is there or not. Yep, our data is there. You see, perfectly data is written with all the information and it's showing 9995 rows. And if you see here, 9995 rows. So these are the successfully written. And if you see here in our tJava output that we have written, number of records inserted is 9995. So this is how you can insert a data lake CSV file to Snowflake table. Okay, so I hope you like this video. Okay.